Hello friends, welcome to Global Online University. This is our 28th episode for paper 1 MCQ series for UGC NET and SET examination. And you can watch our earlier 27 episode. Link for them is given in the description. And if you like this episode, please subscribe to Global Online University. And in this episode, we'll cover MCQs from the topic communication barriers. Moving on to the question. The question is, which of these must be avoided for effective communication? So friends, the effective communication requires a good listening, it requires a politeness, and a sharing of activity are required for effective communication. But ambiguity means some words, their meaning is uncertain. In other words, they have two meanings, more than one meaning. So this more than one meaning will create a confusion. So ambiguity should be avoided. I hope you got this right. So for effective communication, ambiguity should be avoided. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following is external sound present in the channel of communication? So friends, earlier episodes we have learned external sound other than sender and receiver. So that external sound is called noise in communication. So noise is not good for communication. So moving on to the next question. In which of these problems is the actual message is lost in the abundance of transmitted information? So friends, in this case, the information passed is too much. It is more than what is required to pass the message. So in this case, jungle of message, the original message is lost. So this case is called over communication. And a case where the information provided is very little. So you cannot draw a conclusion. So that case is called under communication. Remember this, when there is more information or more than what is required, it is called over communication. And when there is very little information, then it is called under communication. So this case is over communication. Moving on to the next question. Dash dash means to impart the understanding of the message. So friends, if you understand the communication process, first is the sender encodes message, then he pass it through the channel to the receiver. He receives and then he decode the message. Decode means he gets the understanding of what is the message. So the process of imparting understanding of the message is called decoding. So decoding is a receiver decodes message and so take out the understanding from it. Moving on to the next question. The question is, when the communication process completes? So friends, they have asked when communication process ends. So communication process starts with sender encoding the message, then passing it to the channel, then receiver receives it and decodes it. But that decoding means the understanding of the message. So the when receiver understands the message, the communication process completes. I hope you understood this. This was pretty simple. Moving on to the next question. Dash dash is the first enemy of the communication. So friends, we have discussed it. The noise is the first enemy of the communication. The clarity, politeness and completeness are good. And the noise is first enemy of the communication. So noise is also a distortion, distraction. Moving on to the next question. Which of this is not recommended for effective communication? So friends, they have asked which of the following is not recommended. So clarity of language is required, it is recommended. Home communication skill is required. Adequate medium is also required. And poor listening is not required. So this is not recommended for effective communication. Poor listening is not recommended for effective communication. Question is, which of this should not be avoided for effective communication? So here they have asked what should not be avoided. So friends, noise should be avoided, semantic problems should be avoided, wrong assumptions should be avoided, but planning should not be avoided. There should be a proper planning before I give this lecture or any professor gives lecture. There should be a planning. So for proper communication, for effective communication, planning should not be avoided. There should be a planning. So the correct answer will be planning. Moving on to the next question. Question is, dash dash problem are problems arising from the expression. So friends, expression means meaning. So dash dash are the problems arising from the meaning. So friends, when a communication or the message is such that it can lead to two meanings. So, and in that case, it is called semantic problems. So this process is called when there is problem arising out of expression or meaning is called semantic problem. One example of this I can give: a child can be interpreted as a girl, boy, kid. So in many ways, but this is, so it can be, it has more meaning. So in this case, problem arising from the expression, remember, is called semantic problem. Moving on to the next question. Which of these terms refer to the study of speech processes? So friends, this question is for you. So study of speech process is called, what is it called? So you have to answer this in the comment section. I hope you have liked it. Thank you for watching.